So we are live on Facebook and good evening and welcome to this special event for celebrating Mother's Day. So Mother's Day is tomorrow और आज हम लोगों ने सोचा क्यों ना उसे celebrate किया जाए, क्योंकि हम लोग देखते हैं हमारे आजू बाजू में ऐसा जो माहौल है बहुत बहुत दुख का, तनाव का, there is stress, there is anxiety, we are hearing deaths every day. WhatsApp खोलो, Facebook खोलो तो it's very very saddening, you know, we get to see so many news. So we thought, why not let's celebrate a person जिसका हमारे जिंदगी में बहुत ज्यादा मायने रहता है. जब भी हमें बचपन में बहुत कुछ कभी दुख होता था या फिर कभी गुस्सा आता था तो हम कहाँ जाते थे, हम लोग हमारे माँ के आंचल के अंदर छुप जाते थे and we used to feel really really safe. So let's celebrate that unconditional love. तो हमने सोचा क्यों ना एक इवेंट किया जाए और उसमें हम लोग ऐसी जो मदर्स है, ऑफकोर्स एवरी मदर इज स्पेशल एंड दे आर सुपर मॉम्स. So we have over here our super moms. So before that, let me introduce myself. I know, I'm sure everybody knows me by now. I am Aarti Saur, CEO of Parisar Asha, and I'm also holding a voluntary position in Women's Movement, that is executive chairperson. So Parisar Asha is a Mumbai-based not-for-profit organization working in the field of education for past almost 40 years. And Women's Movement is a voluntary organization which started by Times of India Foundation for the upliftment of women, because they believe, you know, Women's Movement believe that women ke paas jo power hai, that power is of compassion and love. Agar women ne apni power ka istemal kiya to shayad ye duniya badal jayegi, you know, there will be more love, there will be more compassion, aur ye jo aaj hum log mahol dekh rahe hain wo shayad na ho. So we thought, why not let's celebrate Women's Day. कुछ तो एक celebration का मौका हमें मिलेगा क्योंकि life is very short. So it's better that we celebrate each and every moment of our life. So यहाँ पे हमारे साथ जो जुड़े हुए हैं वो बहुत celebrated mothers हैं. In fact, they are also normal mothers. They are doing wonderful in their professional lives, but at the same time, they are hardcore mothers and they are also going through a lot of challenges like all of us we are going through. So before that, before I introduce to them, I have written a small poem on mother to dedicate, you know, to all the mothers who are over here and for our mothers also. So here are my four lines. Mere jo kavita ke ek chand panktiya main aap logon ko sunana chahungi with your permission. Maa to sabhi ki hoti hai, par sabki maa pyari hoti hai. वही प्यार वही दुलार, पर हर माँ की कहानी निराली होती है. माँ चाहे मनुष्य की हो, पशु पंछियों की, माँ तो आखिर माँ ही होती है. माँ की ममता जैसे शीतल चांदनी, लोरी की तान बने सुरीली रागिनी. माँ का आंचल जैसे धूप में छाव, शायद इसलिए कभी मेरे जले नहीं पाओ. तूने उंगली पकड़ के चलाना सिखाया, गिरकर फिर उठना सिखाया. दुख में सुख में जीना सिखाया, जिंदगी के रिश्ते निभाना सिखाया. उम्र के हर मकाम पर काश तू साथ होती माँ, तो शायद तुझे बता पाती कि मैं भी जानती हूँ तेरा दर्द, क्योंकि अब मैं भी हूँ एक माँ. सो दिस इज फॉर यू नो गिविंग रिस्पेक्ट एंड यू नो या मिसिंग मदर्स, एंड बहुत खुशनसीब है वो जिनकी होती है माँ और जिनकी नहीं होती. बट ऐसा कहते हैं कि भगवान हर जगह पे नहीं पहुंच पाया, इसके लिए उसने माँ को बनाया. तो अगर आपकी माँ आपके साथ है तो यस, आप बहुत नसीब हो, और अगर नहीं है तो भी उसके आशीर्वाद हमेशा आपके साथ रहेंगे. इसी नोट पे आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट एंड वेलकम आवर चीफ गेस्ट. आज की जो चीफ गेस्ट है वो स्क्रीन की, बॉलीवुड स्क्रीन की बहुत पॉपुलर माँ है. So I welcome you, Smita ji, Smita Jaikar ma'am. Welcome to Parisar Asha and Women's Movement ki jo ek event humne organize ki hai, online event. Luckily aaj sab log kahin se bhi jud sakte hai online event mein. To Smita ji ke bare mein mujhe kuch batane ki zarurat hai nahi, but fir bhi main batana chahungi ki she is amazing actress, transformative speaker, spiritual healer, spiritual guide, writer, author, mother, grandmother and a wonder mom. So I welcome Smita mom. Now I will like to introduce my very dear friend Geeta Castellino. she is an inspiration in herself. She could come over उनकी जो disabilities है उसके ऊपर उभर के आज वो पूरी दुनिया को inspiration देती है. She is an expert in psychology, education, fashion, CSR and corporate consultant. And she is also a well-known figure in Kala Ghoda Festival. She is on the board of Kala Ghoda. And she is a mother of 27-year-old Trusha. Luckily I could get all the mothers of different age groups and different environment. So let's have, you know, like fun talking to each other. Let's discover unke challenges kya the, hamare challenges kya hai, aur kahan pe hum match karte, kahan pe hamari wavelength judti hai. So now I would like to introduce Dr. Sunita Purushottam. Dr. Sunita, welcome. So Dr. Sunita is with Mahindra Life Spaces. She is head of sustainability. And we work very closely with Mahindra Life Spaces. So we have a very interesting project with them for past almost 6 years. हम लोग बच्चों के लिए environment sensitization के लिए एक workshop conduct करते हैं. Almost every year we conduct more than 100 of workshops, जिसमें we sensitize our children for the environmental sustainability and energy conservation. So it's called as Green Army. And due to this COVID, जब भी हम लोगों ने ऑनलाइन करना चालू किया तो now it is called as Green Army Family. So we are reaching out to families and we are spreading the word of, you know, we are creating tomorrow's sustainable individuals for the sustainable society. So welcome, Dr. Sunita. It's lovely to see you over here. Okay, now we have our very young mother, Dhanashri Page. She is operations head CSR Capgemini India, and we are really proud to be associated with Capgemini India. Because of Capgemini's support, we could make our positive parenting and child helpline, which is a mental health helpline for it's a toll free helpline which is absolutely free of cost. So we have our counselors, our psychologists, psychiatrists, doctors on board who are providing free counseling to everyone. In fact, post-COVID, we extended this to for COVID relief also, our helpline. And anybody of any age group, any environment, any religion, any caste, community, gender, they can seek help without any cost. So please, you can, you know, like use this. And especially during this COVID time when we really need that hope. So that's where Parisar Asha has been doing. And it's the hope is there in our name only. It's Parisar is environment and Asha is hope. So I welcome all of you. And Dhanashri is a mother of 4-year-old Rudra. And yeah, I forgot to tell about Dr. Sunita. Sunita is her son is 17, and I think it's the most difficult age where Dr. Sunita is right now, because she's handling a teenage son. So I don't know who's handling whom, that we will get to know now. Am I right, Dr. Sunita? So yeah, welcome. So let me just ask first to Smita ji. Smita ji, aaj aisa mahol hai ki har jagah pe bahut zyada negativity hai. To aise mahol mein aapka mothers ke liye kya advice rahega ki specially during COVID times or in general, you know, like what you would like to tell all age group ki jo mothers yahan pe aaj maujood hai. Like we can see a lot of people, they have joined today, and we are also on Facebook Live, and we will be also posting it on YouTube. Since you are from the spiritual background, and you know, you had been preaching, you had been helping so many families, so many people. So what is, I thought ki this will be the wonderful platform, you know, like jab aapke blessings hum logon ko mile, aapke and aapke do shabd, you know, jisse hame bhi kuch seekhne ko mile, because I think every mother learns every day something new. So and our children, they really teach us so many things. So yeah, Smita ji, over to you.
My children are not children anymore, they are men. So I have a granddaughter who is 6 years old. So these boys are men, they are 35 and 38 years old. So when they were growing up, there was nobody who guided me as to how I should be a mother and what I should tell the children. That awareness was not there back in the days. And I'm sure ma'am, Geeta ma'am would also agree with me on that, because our children are a little older than your children. So we were not ever guided. But today there is a lot of guidance, or there is a lot of awareness as to what a mother or any member of the family can do for the upbringing of the child, for the conditioning of the child. So as you said, that this COVID times, now it doesn't have to be only COVID times that the mother is always conscious of the child or, you know, for the welfare of the child. It is a universal fact everywhere that every age, a mother remains a mother, no matter what, till she dies. However old your children are, they are still your, you will remain a mother till your children die. Because sometimes the mother, kids also get very upset and angry. Stop it, mom, I'm not so young now. These lines we've heard and you'll hear them all the time, but we still, as a mother, we will continue doing that. Now, as a protection, of course, all of us know it's always on the news and WhatsApps and this, that what we should do to protect ourselves now. But where I am coming from now is not addressing to mothers who have older children. But now Dhanashree's child, who's just 4 years old, I'm talking to children, millennium children. I'm talking to mothers of the millennium children. I'm addressing to them. Especially children who are born after 2012. Wherever, whichever family you are born in, even if you're in the slums, the child from the slums, all the children, all these souls have come from some other planet, taken birth on planet Earth to change, to transform the planet. I don't know if you all have heard of this, but these children are all angel children, indigo children, crystal children, and golden children. Now, category wise, I don't know what they do, but you will see how certain children are there. As children, they love environment, they love trees, plants, they love animals, they love pets. Sometimes they say certain things, you wonder, how the hell does this child say these things? You know, you just wonder where the hell this thought comes into this child's head, that they'll go and help some, you know, anybody out of just the feeling that, no, I want to help my grandmother. My mother is still there with me. So when Sahaya, my granddaughter, when she comes home, she'll always take her hand and hold her hand, that little girl, and bring her. You know, it seems, so my mother says, why are you doing this? You see, my name is only Sahaya. So I have to do Sahaya. So she comes up with some silly things, you know. I mean, sometimes you don't realize how the hell does she come. Maybe nobody teaches her. So these children will show certain traits. So what happens, parents are not aware of these energies. Whether they're educated parents or uneducated parents, they're not aware of these energies of these children. So you have to channelize their energies, that these children are not children who are normal. They have come from somewhere else with some different or extra whatever in them. Like this girl, I'll tell you one incident from her school. She was that time 3 years old when she was in school. She goes to cathedral. So they had celebrated Mother's Day. So this girl walks up to the principal's office on her own. And she says, you know, ma'am, I know my Guruji has taught me a Mother Earth prayer. Can I tell you? So the principal was shocked, coming from a three-year-old child. She said, yes, Saya, what is it? So she said the prayer to her. So the principal caught her hand, took her to her class and say, now teach these children, all your class people, about the Mother Earth prayer. So she sat on the ground, cross-legged, and told the children the instructions, whatever, and she said that Mother Earth prayer, and the children repeated after her. Now, nobody has taught her these things. Three-year-old child getting all these kind of things, I mean, it's a little impossible to fathom, you know. So this is what I mean. So maybe your children, maybe Dhanashree, if you've observed, your child is 4. So he's also that small. So you must have observed some traits about that child, that I don't know how this child is like that. Now, sometimes this is the shlokas, the mantras, pataput, 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 they will say, who's taught them all these things? So I'm just, whoever is watching this, I'm bringing you into this awareness of these parents of children, especially born after 2012. We need to really take care of them or understand their energies. Otherwise, their energies are just going to go haywire, you know, without me using and utilizing the energies in the right channel. So I would like to say that, of course, COVID times, I will tell anybody and everybody who's watching this program is, it is so fearful and scary, the whole scenario outside. Please stop watching television and stop listening to news. Because the fear psychosis is worse than the disease. honestly, and to build your immunity and all, you take your own care. And the best thing to do is to breath watch. Your breath can cure anything. If you have nothing to do in life, watch your breath. This develops your immunity also, makes your immunity get stronger. And that's the best thing to do. Sit at home quietly and don't just make a big noise out of it. Fear has the power to manifest itself. So let's not get into this fear psychosis and scare everyone around and spread it like this. That's the advice I would give to people who are watching as far as COVID things are concerned. But from mother's point of view, I would really like to get this thought into young parents just now. Parents of young children, rather. To be in this awareness, because that's very essential for today's children, for their further growth. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And one more question over here. Especially you said ki about mothers and parents, you know, like how they can get rid of this fears, but then what about children? Because how do we protect children also from these kind of news? Because I think children today, they are not able to even socialize. मुझे बच्चों का जो आज का एक बच्चों का जो धर्म है खेलने का वो भी आज बंद हो गया है कंप्लीटली. सो व्हाट विल बी योर यू नो एडवाइस टू
दैट्स अ चैलेंज फॉर द मदर्स टू कीप देयर चिल्ड्रन रियली ऑक्यूपाइड विद समथिंग नाइस. इट्स रियली डिफिकल्ट टू डू दैट. आई नो इट्स अ वेरी चैलेंजिंग सिचुएशन. ईच चाइल्ड अकॉर्डिंग टू हिज नेचर एंड द वे द मदर पेरेंट मदर पेरेंट चाइल्ड रिलेशनशिप इज एवरी चाइल्ड हैज गॉट सम intuitive thing for art maybe or singing maybe or something they do have, so engross them more in that. Besides this, online schools are going on, so now the chuttiyan shuru ho gayi hain abhi, but online schools are going on, so they're busy for half a day, you know, and then you have to really if that's a challenging situation that I really don't, if the children are very small, they don't understand.
Right.
4, 5, 6 years old, they are not into this, they don't know anything, you know, they don't get bored and all. Like teenagers, like Dr. Sunita ma'am, her child, a teenager child, to hold a child at home and to make entertain him, that is a difficult task which I really don't know how to help. Older children, like what Geeta ma'am has, my kids are, of course, they're beyond it all, they're men, so that is a different question. But older children can be made to understand, they understand the situation. This age group, this teenage group, this is a really difficult, it's a challenging task, and I really don't know how to make them really understand, because we have to make them understand that the situation is like this and not to go out. You can't go out. They have to protect themselves and people at home. That much of a emotional blackmail one can do with the children.
In fact, here I would like to tell our audience ki we have started with the summer camp. So this is our second summer camp starting from Monday. So if anybody has missed out on that opportunity, please, you can, you know, join. And Dhanashree, for your age group also, we are coming up with something very shortly.
Yeah.
So you can make use of this online facility where we have art, dance, drama, you know, everything. And yes, it's not only about this, but about, you know, behavioral changes, what we try to, you know, make through this particular exercise.
Has really blown out.
Yeah, it's a very holistic kind of, you know, summer camps what we usually prefer to. And luckily Parisar Asha is a very talented team. Geeta ma'am knows, and Dr. Sunita, Dhanashree, they all know my team very well. So yeah, and wonderful, Smita ma'am, thank you so much for your advice and guidance. One very, you know, tricky question I want to ask you.
Why all these tricky questions to me?
Yeah, because you are the most senior most person over here, and you are, you can say enlightened person, enlightened soul.
This is Ram sir going on now.
So, we are always like, not actually our generation, the next generation, like Dhanashree's generation, I'm saying, you know, ki jahan pe mothers, like, because we get many cases on our helpline also, ki jahan pe mothers are into dilemma ki feminism and motherhood. बहुत वहां पे ना क्लैशेस हो जाते हैं कि मतलब क्या चूज करूं, मैं ये चूज करूं या वो चूज करूं. तो इसका आपका क्या ख्याल है ये बारे में, मतलब फेमिनिज्म एंड मदरहुड, व्हाट आर योर यू नो आई मीन इट्स इट कैन बी योर पर्सनल ओपिनियन.
वेरी ऑनेस्टली, फेमिनिज्म इज टेकन टू अनदर एक्सटेंट बाय पीपल, इट इज ब्लोन आउट ऑफ प्रोपोर्शंस. I mean, you as a woman, yes, I need that respect from my from the male members of the house or outside. Yes, to that extent, yes. But women have stepped out of their role and have started wearing the pants in the house, and there is where a little bit of a imbalance is that happen, and they scream out feminism. Feminism doesn't mean go fight unnecessarily, break relations, anything happens between you and your husband, pick up your bag and just walk out. That is not feminism. Feminism is respect the feminine part of me, the feminine embodiment in me. That is what I expect for anybody, for another woman to a woman and from a man to a woman. That is feminism. Now, we have not understood only the concept. So the motherhood is a part of feminism. I mean, to be a mother, to have two souls in your body at one time, is a big vardhan or a boon given to us by the divine. How much of shakti we women have? Why don't you utilize that shakti in a positive way? Why do women go down? Why do they misconstrue everything? Why can't they take it in a positive way? Feminism ka matlab yahi nahi ki chalo nare lagao udhar ja ke jhagda karo udhar usko uska uksao udhar usko uksao koi divorce ho raha hai to talk only for the woman not for the man, which is many times so wrong. Sometimes women also act really funny. I mean, I've known so many cases that they really do things ridiculously, and the man is maligned and the man is thrashed for something that he's really not done. So that is not feminism. So let's get that whole concept right of feminism. So whatever feminism karke, even this Me Too thing for that matter. You remember Me Too thing that just recently, Me Too thing, so many men were wrongly implied and wrongly, charged and what all was happening. In fact, there was a movie on that Me Too thing. I forget the name of that movie. How the woman, Akshay Khanna was in that film. Richa Sharma and Akshay Khanna. They were playing the lawyers. You must see that film.
Yeah, it was some about section something, right?
Article something. Those two films.
Yeah. I've seen that film. Yeah, wonderful film. Yeah.
So how that woman unnecessarily blames that man, and that man just gets into this kind of. So many women have taken advantage of this fact, which is not feminism again. This is not correct to misuse things just because you're a woman, to misuse certain rights that you have got. I don't consider that as feminism at all. So let's get the concept right first. 377, somebody, section 377.
Yeah, thank you,
madam. That movie, fabulous. So the whole word feminism, I don't like it only because it is just completely blown out of proportion. I don't believe in it at all.
So thank you so much, Sita ma'am, for your frank opinion. And I move on to Dr. Sunita. Dr. Sunita, the same question goes to you. What are your views about feminism and motherhood? Or have you ever gone through such kind of a dilemma anytime in your life? If you can share with our audience.
So I don't think it is a dilemma, because there is no this or that. I mean, in sense that motherhood is never a or, it is always there, right? So the dilemma was other way around, actually, because when my son was born, I couldn't bear to leave him and go and work. So I I didn't like the separation, though I would of course go out, do my exercise, or take my scooter out, or take the car out and go for a spin or something like that, just to get respite from all the motherly duties just after he was born. But I don't think it's a or this or that. He's always there, or I'm always a mother and I have to do all the other things. So it's not a dilemma. But as I wanted to start my career again, that was a time that I went through a little bit of a tussle. I had to leave him at a daycare, and I came back from US where my husband was working. At that time, a lot of women over there said that you are going to be choosing your work over him, and you are going back to India, where women actually yearned to come to US and stay with their partners. And I chose to come back because I had got an opportunity, and I came back with my son. So for my son, it was not a or. it was probably for my husband. It was husband or, you know, my work and motherhood. For him, I was there. But of course, the separation was a little bit difficult for me. And I did work for some time and came back to US, and they allowed me to work from home. And I don't know whether I should call it a dilemma. I don't know whether I should call it a dilemma or a this or a that, but I wanted to get back to work. And I don't know whether I should call that feminism either, because it's coming from me that I want to get back to work. I want to be useful. So that for me is not feminism. It's my wish, and I would want to do what I have set out to do. Yeah. So it was my inner call, and I did go through the tussle. And then when I came back again, I joined Infosys. That's the time I got a very good helper, and I sent him to a day boarding, and then she would, you know, after he would come back, take care, and I would be back home by 6. So I managed. So I don't think between what you know, we have our right to work, which some may call it feminism, but it's the, you know, what you want to do, right? So it's never between this or the other. You can't stop being a mother. So the child is always a priority. So it may appear for others that my child may not be a priority because I'm out there, right? But it's not the case, actually. So that's, maybe it's my inner tussle.
So let me ask you another question. So what are your experiences as weekend mother?
And weekend mother.
Maybe you can share, you know, weekend mother. Yeah, we have heard weekend husbands, but now we have a case where it's weekend mother. Yeah.
So yes, I stay in Pune, and my head office is in Varli. So I was going up and down, and I was definitely a weekend mother, and I was getting respite from being all my household duties. Yeah, weekend mother is like my son would want to sit with me and talk to me more. Even now when I'm busy throughout the day, at night he'll catch hold of my phone, put it aside, and say, "Now you talk to me." Right. So weekend mother is more of cooking, making the things that he likes, probably a little bit of baked items or food, and then spend a little bit of time with him. He yearns for my company. So it's tough, but I don't think it's unmanageable. So the experience has been good, I would say. The only challenge I found was that he doesn't talk too much on phone. So there was a little bit of a, you know, kya chal raha hai, pad raha hai ki nahi, kuch kar raha hai ki nahi. So all of that monitoring was not happening. So I was on the study front, you know, because he even now at home, if you tell him, no, where are you? What have you done? There is no, you know, feedback mechanism that comes, especially on studies. So that's the worrying point. I'm not there to monitor all the work that he is doing.
So any family se aapko kuch support mila ya fir kuch taane baane sunne ko mile?
Taane baane har ek se sunne ko milta hai. Every person, the action that I took to come back, you know, leave my husband, poor husband over there, all the women in the women's group, like, you know, how could you do that? Your husband needs you. Your son has a better upbringing here in US. You're going back to India. Okay, so I heard a lot. Then this also I heard quite a lot. And I normally don't say where I am, what I do. So that's one way. In fact, I didn't tell many of my family members that I work in Bombay. There are very few people who knew, and especially, the older generation can't handle it. And so my cousins could, but many people I haven't mentioned, and I've told my mom that, please, you know, I'm in Pune, I'm with my family, and I'm working. So
I hope they are not watching this.
I have given few of them the links, but it was like May not be overt, but many people, you know, might have thought, you know, ki kya zarurat hai, ki zarurat kahan se hai ki sab kuch chhod ke, you know, you go and do something else. What is the need? Sometimes I also question that, what is the need? But yeah, you get to hear. And sometimes I don't give the information. Many people don't know in my society, you know, that where I work, what I do. But some people observe, you know, haan, ye rehti nahi hai.
Kaha rehti hai?
Kaha rehti hai?
Yeah. So, yeah, I know there are a lot of challenges when you take such decisions in life. But, yeah, as far as you are happy and you are taking care of your family and, you know, all our responsibilities and I think that should not be, you know, and your son is now 17. I think that time they also need their space, so-called space. So, yeah, now coming to Dhanashree, the youngest mother in our group today. So, Dhanashree was, I mean, we had worked very closely with Dhanashree on the project. And that time I have realized ki, she had that time, I think, 2-year-old son, right? Abhi 2 saal pehle ki baat hai. And this is, I'm talking before COVID. Ki COVID ka, abhi COVID mein to sab log hi ghar se kaam kar rahe hain. But before COVID, I had seen the way her family and especially company, Capgemini, they had been, you know, very strong support of Dhanashree. Am I right, Dhanashree?
Yes, yes, of course. So even when, you know, before work from home was normalized, I was allowed to work, right? So I almost worked from home for a year and a half. So I had that system. And luckily, I have a very good support system at home front as well. So even I stay in Pune and we are a joint family. So it's like 9 members together. We have cousins. So although Rudra is my only child, but he's not raised as one. So they are, you know, 3 cousins together. And what my in-laws have also told me, you know, that you've achieved, you know, a few things you have learned, you know, you should continue. And because of that strong support, I had no need of even extending one day of my maternity. So I was, you know, continuing right after it. And it was from home. So I was giving those flexi hours. You know, I used to work sometimes in early morning, late night, again, depending on, you know, the sleeping schedules and everything. And that is something I felt was a very good support and good motivation as well to continue working. Because what I can say, especially in terms of Capgemini, it's not just one-off, you know, that just because your manager is supportive that you get these perks. But this is something which has been institutionalized. We have those policies in place which are enabling, you know, enough to ensure that this continuum is there. We have certain programs which also have that buddy support, you know, so when even you're on your maternity leave, you are tagged to a buddy who helps you with, you know, what's going on, what's happening. Luckily for me, I was sure that, you know, it's the same team, it's the CSR team that I have to join. I knew, you know, that this would be the work I'll be doing. But that's not the case with most of the, you know, women who are in the technical jobs, which are mostly short-term assignment basis. So again, there they have those, you know, training, those mentoring support as well, you know, to ensure that it's streamlined, it's smooth, and then the transition happens seamlessly in that.
Wonderful. So, Dhanashree, can you share, I mean, your experiences during COVID on a personal front? Because everybody, I mean, you are representing this new generation mother who's working, who's taking care of home and, you know, taking care of child. And during pandemic, everybody is at home. So how did you manage? And especially now children, like your child is in that age group where he's not supposed to be exposed to a lot of screen time. But Abhi, schools bhi sab online ho gaye hain. So how did you manage this entire situation? And yeah, plus you got a promotion also. I mean, hats off to you during this pandemic.
So thank you for that. Earlier, so in the 2020, the earlier phase of lockdown was a bit tough. You know, we all were overwhelmed what to do. The working hours got extended. So it was not typical, you know, you shut your system and then it's off. But it needed some long hours, certainly, you know, late night calls as well. And then there was also somewhere a self-imposed pressure that, you know, I need to keep my child entertained. And then that is where it was causing a big stress there, you know, that now do this. Okay, now he's not sitting here, right? I can't see him, you know, where he is. So then later what we realized is, although we have toys, we have those books, but he was playing with very limited toys. So what we did was, we kept those with whom he's playing regularly. We made sure he has access to all the cushions, all the bed sheets, and all the utensils in the kitchen. And then it's all sorted in that sense. And that's what we realized, you know, it's instead of having that controlled presence of yours, it's better to keep them free. At times, he just gets bored, and then he makes his own poems, makes his own stories, and he's on his own now. And what we have also seen is we do follow a no-screen thing. So although he's a four-year-old, he is now enrolled, but his school will start in July. So only Sunday is the day, you know, when we allow him for the screen time. Rest is all play. So we have little garden, so he plays in the mud. So it's okay. So we are okay to handle that mess. And again, on the family front, what we are observing is our house is enough clean to be healthy, but enough dirty to be happy. So it's like nobody gets stressed out if there's soil everywhere. So it's perfectly fine. And he enjoys his time. We get, you know, some focused time as well to do things that we like to do on personal front. And it applies for everybody around. So that's how we we learned that. But it's now going for much fun.
So you are having good time with your child.
Yes.
Good.
Yes.
So yeah, coming to Geeta. Geeta, you have been, you know, versatile, and hats off to you. I mean, in spite of all the challenges what you faced in your life, you are a role model for so many. So how did you manage? Because I heard that your husband used to be also, you know, like on ship. So he was away from house, plus, I mean, managing home front and, you know, raising a child into such a beautiful individual, and plus doing whatever you have achieved in your career. Ye sab aapne kaise hasil kar liya? Matlab, how did you manage all these things? And whether your mother also played a very important role in that entire thing?
Yeah, I think every mother plays a very significant role in a child's life. But I think mine was much more than that. Maybe countless sacrifices were there, or giving her privacy or her alone time to make me or her children. There are three siblings, basically. So it could be just to thrive, to make them thrive. She's definitely sacrificed herself quite a bit. And more than that, what also happened was when I was 2.5 years, my elder sister was 7 that time, and my younger brother was just 4 months when I got polio. So during that time, I'm sure the whole family was completely aghast about the whole situation, what happened. And the time came, my mother was also a working woman. So she had to leave her job. And then almost for 11 years, every day from 8 o'clock in the morning till 5:30 in the evening, I used to have all the therapies which she had to come up with me to do everything, like from physiotherapy to occupational therapy to speech therapy, because I had lost my speech also, basically. Along with that, swimming for 1.5 hours every day, I used to do swimming. So all these kinds of things took up all her time only on me. So again, both other siblings were there. So she had to also look after them. But I think my grandparents were also there, who were of great help, my mother's parents. And we stayed in their house, basically. So I think my mother definitely plays an important role of what today I am. And for me, what I have learned from her basically is definitely she was a motivational factor for me. Definitely, another thing is dedication. What dedication is, what motivation is, or what passion is. All that I have learned from her. Time management, I've learned, I think, from the time I was 2.5 years, because the way she used to manage everything from morning till evening with cooking and everything. Every woman goes through all these things, that family life, whatever at home, what you do and everything. I get a feeling that every woman has to struggle with both ends. And that is exactly what she did. And she did it extremely well, I think, because the confidence level which I got is all only because of her, because they treated me, the family also treated me like a normal child. So I was not treated like somebody who's a physical challenge is there. So, chalo isko jara baju mein rakhe, ye kaam mat karna. So it was nothing of that sort. And we came from a middle class family. So education was something which was very important.
So that also, I think, was inculcated in us that you must get educated and you must stand in your on your two feet, whatever circumstances happen, not to depend on anybody. So I think my mother has definitely played a role. More than that, I will say that when you talked about my husband also, after we got married and when we got Thusha, when she was born, actually, my husband was stuck up at sea. He's an engineer and he was stuck up at sea and he could not come even for the delivery. So a time came the previous day, he called up and he said, it's impossible. And I said, you just tell me that you're not coming and then I will prepare myself. So till one day before I delivered, I was still working. I was working as a professor at SNET. And a time came, he actually came and he first saw her when she was 2.5 months old. So my parents were the ones and my in-laws were the ones who actually took proper care of those 2 months in a very well manner. More than that, also that once he came back for 1 year, he did not go back to sea. So he was there to help me out. More than that, he completed everything for our daughter. So it was really good because the thing is for me, though it looks that very normal, everything is normal, there are definitely problems and there are problems in such a way. Things which I cannot do. I can run away from them. So there are times when I could not even pick her up and walk and things like that. So that was okay, you know, because I adjusted, my family adjusted, my husband adjusted, and he took care of her like a mother. So that was really good. And I was also working. So after 6 months of my maternity leave, when I went back, we had to also keep her in the creche. But that was only after when he started going back again to see. But before that, I think when I used to go to college and come back and he used to take proper care of her. So that was not a problem. When while growing up, yes, definitely when he wasn't there, a lot of times when you are alone and you are doing things for your child, when nobody's there in the house, a lot of decisions also need to be taken. There are times when these decisions are there, very crucial kind of decisions. And I had to take those decisions. I feel that being a professional mother and a working woman, that also helped because then you know how to manage your time basically. And many of the times we feel that we are super moms. So you want to do everything right and everything should be perfect. But there are times when you need to even adjust. I remember when Dr. Sunita ji was talking about and Smita ji, when she was talking about, I could completely relate with what she was talking about. When Dr. Sunita was talking about her son that, you know, he hardly talks now. I can give you one example is that when Thusha was in senior KG, and what I used to also, I have a big complex because other moms, when I used to go for parent-teachers meetings, at that time I used to realize that I'm not that typical mother kind of a mother, you know. So I used to many a times think that, oh, am I a good mother or not? When I used to look at the other moms at PTA. So those meetings, I used to see, and the moms used to be so hyper and they know what page, which poem is, which I wouldn't know also. And these are the times I used to really get scared. I used to talk to the class teacher and I said, you know, I don't know anything what Thusha is doing. Because Thusha's funda was like this. Every time I would come from college, I used to say, Thusha, so what did you do today to school? So one day she got so irritated and she was just looking at me and she said, Mama, stop asking me what I did at school because school ka kam school mein, ghar ka kam ghar mein. So I'm not going to tell you what happened there. I'm not going to say anything in school, what happened there. And then I got actually scared. So I went to the teacher and said, no, this is how she talks. This is what she's telling me now. How do I handle it? She said, don't worry. Unless and until I complain to you, don't bother. You don't have to have complaints because other mothers know so much that we face the concept poem or concept listening. And I've, like, even today, Thusha always tells me that, you know, you were a very weird kind of a mom because you never bothered about marks. But that is how I was. And I think that was something which I think was inculcated in me even from my family when I was growing up also. I was an average student and nobody bothered basically. Like, you just pass and, like, I used to always tell her, to, if you want to pass and whatever marks you're getting, it's up to you. That is, if it's difficult, you have, it's your problem, I don't know anything. She always says, which kind of a mother? Today she tells me, which kind of a mother say something like this to a child at the age of six that tumhara problem tumhara hai, ha, tumko agar karna hai to karo, nahi hai to fail ho jaoge, it doesn't matter. So it was that way, but I think that attitude also helped to a certain extent, whatever, because the kind of decisions she makes today and the kind of, because after 10th standard she started going out, she went out and then even graduation, everything she did on scholarship in USA and things like that. But I think graduation, position, whatever she did, she could manage on her own, I think, because she became independent. I think most of you also will agree with me, or even Smita ji, Sunita ji or Dhanash ji will agree that being a working woman, I think our children become very, very independent. And that is what actually matters at the end of the day. That's what I feel.
Yeah, wonderful. Geeta ji, we will talk to you. There are many questions which we would like to ask you. So before that, Smita ji has to leave by 7:30. She has another session now. So in her presence, I would like to, you know, announce that there is a Mother's Day gift for all the mothers from Parisar Asha. So Parisar Asha has been working with the schools for so many years, and we have our own publication, which we used to give it to the schools. But unfortunately, during pandemic, what has happened is schools are not functional and mothers and especially parents, they have to take care of their children. So iske liye hum log abhi tak humne kabhi nahi kiya in 40 saalon mein. Because we always believe that, you know, school ka kaam school mein hi karna chahiye. And whatever publication, what we have is a worksheet books that used to actually followed by the activities which teachers used to conduct in the school. But what happened is during pandemic, everything is online. And now children, they have to sit at home, and they have been, you know, like last year also during pandemic, they have been working with school teachers, but at home. So we thought, why not? And abhi with this second wave of pandemic, we don't know what is the scene about schools again. So that's where we thought, let's, you know, launch this publication. So we have started with e-cart on our Parisar Asha's website. So I would like in the presence of all of you, and especially Smita ji, with your blessings and with your, you know, gracious hands, of course, I can't give it to you in your hand. But these are our worksheet books, which we are making it open. Like these are from nursery till standard 7, all subjects. These are worksheet books, which are being very popular with schools. And so many schools, more than 3,000 schools have been, you know, associated with us in the past. But these are, we are keeping it open for all the parents and mothers, especially. They can place their orders on our website, on our e-cart. So Sukada, can you just quickly show that video?
Arti ma'am, can you see my screen?
Yeah, I can see, but we can't see anything. You can start. Yes. Yeah, thank you, Sukada. So you can visit our Parisarasha website, www.parisarasha.com, and you can place the orders of our worksheet books, and it will get courier to your place. So this is our Parisarasha's website, and you can buy online our books. Yeah. So thank you. And Smita ji, it was really wonderful. So before you leave, last request to you, agar aap hamare jo darshak hai, jo audience yahan pe hai, maujood hai, unke liye kuch kehna chahenge, like not specially only addressing to mothers, because mothers are part of the entire family. So what about, you know, if your advice to the family, especially during these challenging times, how they can keep the harmony in place? Because sab log saath mein hai, एक दूसरे का साथ इतना अभी तक उन्होंने कभी एक दूसरे को झेला नहीं है, बड़ा झेल रहे सब लोग एक दूसरे को. सो ऐसे में क्या आप उनको क्या एडवाइस देना चाहेंगे, क्या कुछ टिप्स देना चाहेंगे कि विच दे कैन यू नो उनके जो डेली जो लाइफस्टाइल है उसके अंदर इफ दे कैन इंक्लूड दोस काइंड ऑफ टिप्स, सो दैट विल बी हेल्पफुल फॉर देम टू keep their mind cool and even the family environment very good, because children, they really need that good family environment so that they can become a very strong, you know, good personalities. Yeah, Smita ma'am, over to you.
Not children only, but the world at large, whoever is watching this in this difficult time, the whole world is going through this. It's no point complaining, oh, I am suffering, I'm this is that, this is that. Of course, there are the times are challenging, there's no doubt about it. There is no doubt about it. But now we have to tide over times, okay? We have to, and human mind or human bodies or human psyche is created in such a way that we do find ways. When we are pushed to a corner, we find ways. Instead of succumbing, or lots of people commit suicide and they go into depression, instead of succumbing, you have to tide, you have to find a way out. You cannot give up on situations like this. Now, the only way, like I would say it from my point of view, from the spiritual point of view, what my master, Maitreya Dadashri ji, always tells us, at this trying times, the only thing your savior is to connect with your own higher sacred self or your own divine or whoever you believe in. Whether you're a child or whether you're an old person, at this moment, we have no other choice. We have scientists, this, that, and the other. We've gone to the Mars. We've gone wherever, science, technology, everything has gone to another level, but yet we still cannot find what to handle, how to handle this coronavirus thing. It's been going on and on. So unless we turn within, we don't have an answer to this. That's the only answer. Outside, the answers are not there. Turn within, connect with your higher sacred self, connect with your divine. Goodness has to prevail, period. The day humanity understands this, you will see a transformation, you will see a change. And for that, we have to turn inwards. The divine has got us all to our knees. The earlier we understand this, the better it is. You can have whatever you want, but the greed, you know, if you want 10 clothes or 365 clothes to wear every day, new, fine. But why do you have 665 clothes? So this extra, we can cut off this greed, you know, everything you store. Look at the thing that I was ashamed of myself. Last year when this lockdown happened, I had about 5 suits, which were 5 new clothes, which I had, which are still sitting there. But I've never had an opportunity or an occasion to wear them. It is such a shame. And then you realize, see, what is all this nonsense? What have we done? Hoarding, collecting. So the earlier you realize this, that the only answer to this is goodness. Share and spread goodness and turn within. That's all we need to do. Whoever you are, even if you are small children, inculcate these good habits right from now. That's what we need to do. I think that's my prayer. We all of us are praying. All the spiritual institutions, the masters, everyone is just praying to Mother Earth for the transformation. It's really too much now.
Yeah. So thank you so much, Smita ji. It was wonderful having you over here. So for Smita ji, I think we have one more session with her. She will be coming. She will be joining us on this Tuesday in our leadership webinar. So don't miss that opportunity to hear her and, you know, inspire all the leaders out here. And In fact, it's not that all the leaders, every person is a leader. Agar aap mother hai, to bhi aap leader ho, aap father hai, to bhi aap leader ho. You are leading, you are showing to your children. So please do join us on this Tuesday. Smita ji will be conducting leadership webinar. And at 6 o'clock, we will see you over there. And thank you so much, Smita ji, for, you know, blessing us over here. And it was really wonderful having you over here as a chief guest. Thank you so much. And we will continue talking to all other panelists now. So thank you so much, Smita ji. Almost 1929.
Yeah.
So it's exact dot 7:30.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Bye-bye. Love you. Thank you.
Yeah, bye. Take care. Yeah, bye. Yeah, so we'll continue with Geeta ji. Geeta, I think you have little, network issue.
Yeah, oh.
Yeah. There is little network issue. Geeta, now it's fine. But when you were talking, there was a lag in between. Yeah. So, Geeta, what is your advice to, Divyang mothers and also mothers with Divyang kids?
Yeah, okay. First of all, I was brought up like thinking that I'm normal. So, I mean, I never thought myself as Divyang. And because of that, I think I could achieve much more. Because then every time it was never to say never. You know, that was the thing which my family and my mother always said. So that was one thing which made me do a lot of things which maybe I wouldn't have been able to do if that support was not there. So when it comes to Divyang mothers to say something, I think I always tell the normal mothers when I do counseling or when I'm there in any of the webinars or seminars or conferences, I always tell people that even for normal people, I say that if I can do it, anybody can do it. So that's exactly what I feel, because each and every person will be able to manage how much ever disability you have. You will be able to manage. There are things which you cannot run away from things and say that, no, but I can do it. But actually, you cannot. If you cannot do something, then you delegate that to a family member. You depend on the family member to do things. But I think there should not be any such thing that I cannot have a child or I cannot manage to bring my child because I have a disability. Because that cannot be the thing. Anybody and everybody can be a very good mother. And I think that stops at that, because I feel that everybody will be able to experience that motherhood at the same time. The child also understands. And we are not putting that child into any kind of trouble because you are physically challenged or whatever. So I think the mothers who are Divya should not actually be so scared about the thing that, you know, how am I going to manage? Because I think if your life partner is also very supportive, if your in-laws are supportive, your parents are supportive, whoever you are staying with, maybe if you're staying in a joint family also, or if you're on your own. I think with me, it was much more better that we were separately living as a nuclear family, because I could independently do more things and I became more confident because of that. So everything depends on each individual basically. When it comes to Divyang child, I think main thing is communication. Communication with your family as well as with that child. If the child has some special needs, but that child has other siblings, then never to make the child feel that he or she is completely different from others. Inclusive education should start from home. And I think that is something where when you know that other normal children are around, you all play out with that and then have the positive thinking and start bringing up the child in a very, very normal way, which makes that child feels that he or she is capable of doing much more than what they can actually do.
Thank you so much, Geeta ma'am. It was really wonderful. And let me tell all the audience that, you know, I was just chatting with all the panelists and I was asking them, let's share, you know, like some embarrassing moments, you know, of our children. And when they are kids, especially, you know, like they put you in such an embarrassing situation sometimes, or that fun kind of situation. So Dhanashree was very, you know, like, I think she did not respond or react on that because her child is really cute and small. But we have the other grown up, you know, mothers of grown up kids who said, ki, nahi, nahi, I don't think our child is, you know, like put us in any embarrassing situation. We are the ones who put them into embarrassing situations. And same goes with me also. So let's share our embarrassing situation. Maybe when the, you know, like we put our children into embarrassing situation, and Dhanashree will share, you know, like the other way, because the kid is still innocent and small. Yeah, so we'll start with Dhanashree.
Okay, so as I said, so nothing embarrassing as such, but what I could ensure is. What I ensure is, as I said, you know, no screen time that we are ensuring. But all his meals, so I ensure that it's without even me having my mobiles, you know, it's when we talk. And then at times, you know, when I have these calls, he asks, you shouldn't take it, don't take it, I need you, you come here. And then once, you know, we were having dinner and it just came up, you know, I had a late night call. He said, why do you need to work? So I asked him, what do you think? So he said, I think it's because it's your career choice. And for me, that was something, you know, coming from a four-year-old. So not even four, so he'll turn four in August. But I think that is something which is helping. So as Geeta ma'am said, right, so this starts from home. So it's something you start with the very young age. And, you know, what I do is I include him in the kitchen. So, you know, he knows the whole spices, you know, different kinds of spoons. So I mean, that is something, you know, is a learning, because I've seen many of my colleagues, many of my friends struggling, you know, because of this lockdown. Many said we are frustrated that we can't even cut, you know, vegetables properly. So it's like, you can't just expect somebody that now you're a grown up, now you do these things, you know, it's something which starts. And I think that was something which was a really satisfactory, which gave me an immense pleasure that, you know, in some way or the other, I'm connected. At times, you know, so we have those barriers. So he asks, do you have a long call? It's a short call. Is it okay if I come to your desk? So, and then he understands. So there are days when it's like nothing doing, I want you right now. But then I think that's the fun, you know, that's what is making it, you know, happier. And that's the environment we have.
Okay, good. So Dr. Sunita.
So I'm the one who always puts him in a spot. I've done many things. I mean, which is totally embarrassing, but I do it. And one thing that he keeps telling me that I shouldn't be doing is we are three sisters. And if we three sisters are on a call, we are like, you know, and all of that. So that is what he abhors, that, you know, mom, this is one thing that you need to change in yourself. Why do you have to tell? Why do you have to share? This is something that you shouldn't be doing. And he's deadly serious about it. And especially if it is about him, then to I've had it. That, you know, Masi ko batane ki zarurat nahi thi, you know, or and if he observes that, you know, I have said something about somebody to one another person, I have had it that day. So I'm really trying to change that. But, you know, with sisters or with friends, we just, you know, are sharing, and like, ye to hai nahi na pas mein.
No,
he said I will watch because you're going to talk about me. Oh God. So it's like, it's, I have to watch out.
Already, he has given the censored kind of thing. So you cannot share many things.
हाँ ज़्यादा नहीं बोलना मेरे बारे में तो बिल्कुल नहीं बोलना है हाँ दूसरों के बारे में भी third party को बोलना ही नहीं है. So that's one thing that he's observed, and he's like, mom, that's terrible about you. You need to learn. So I'm trying.
Good. Yeah, Geeta, would you like to share something?
I don't know. I think I will, like what others are saying is exactly the same, and what you said also. I think I have embarrassed Trusha more than, I don't think she's anytime embarrassed me. So it's like, and I do all kinds of weirdest of things that sometimes used to say that, you know, I have to go and talk to your students and tell them that what your director does. So, you know, so it's like, it's sometimes it's like that time I used to really get scared. What if by any chance she really meets somebody and talks something, some nonsense things, what I do with her and talk to her and stuff like that. But one incident I think I will tell you, when she was like maybe 3.5-4 years, and that was the time I had started my first institute, which I started, Fashion Institute, and I was the principal there, and she was about 3.5 years that time. And when I was driving, one of the days I was driving with her, and at a signal when we stopped, these beggars come. So usually I give the beggars, I don't pay them, but I always give them biscuit, chocolates, whatever is there in the car. So I was just talking to this guy, and he was like maybe in his 40s. So I was saying that ab kaam kyun nahi karte itne sab ekdam dhatte katte dikh rahe ho, to ab kaam bhi karna chahiye, to aapko kuch kaam chahiye to bolo. And then like she was just telling me, yeah, bol do na usko ki apply kare to usko bhi ek principal ka job de do. So you know, it's like, thankfully the signal started and I had to move. But she was saying that unko usko rukao, usko bolo ki apply kar do, to principal ka job to mil jayega usko. I said, oh, mera job jayega abhi.
No, I know these kids are so smart. Like if I try to tell my daughter something, then she gives me dhamki. She said, I'll call you on your helpline number. Tere against complain karungi karke.
You see, like nowadays what she always tells me, please, whenever you have to share anything from WhatsApp, please, because I always believe everything, whatever is being said. So she says, please share with me, then I will tell you whether it is genuine or not. Then only you must share it with everybody. Said, okay, fine.
So it's wonderful, actually, you know, being mother. I think this is the greatest joy anybody can ever have. I keep on telling all my colleagues who are not planning their kids, and you know, like they nowadays, this younger generation, you know, like they don't want to get into this. I said, no, but I'm so happy that one of my colleagues, she actually listened, and after 14 years, she is, you know, like she had baby. So I think as a woman, everybody should experience this, you know, joy of motherhood. It's, I mean, we cannot explain. Once you become a mother, you really understand. So this is something, you know, which I think only women are privileged to get that joy. So on this note, I think let's, you know, conclude this. And if we'll keep it open for everyone, if anybody would like to, you know, like share something, or, you know, like chat, or share their experiences, or ask our panelists something. So it's open forum now for all of you. And, you know, you can also share your some funny incidences. We would be also very happy to, you know, listen to that. But better be careful. Whatever you share is going Facebook live. So your children, agar aapko ghar pe rehna, so you have to filter some things. So now it's open for everyone, and it was really wonderful having all of you over here. Rajul Gorad, yeah, she raised hands. Yeah, please.
Yeah, Rajul Gada here.
Yeah. Yes.
I'm also a mother like Dhanashri ma'am. I'm more than 4-year-old Parigada's mom. So it's like my husband has to lock the phone, you know. She downloads anything she likes on the phone. While watching videos, while playing games, she downloads anything she likes. So, you know, we have to take care. She will explain, ke, Mama, you should download like this. Ye aise karna chahiye, waise karna chahiye. So they become our parents, you know, like for explaining the app and everything. So that's what I wanted to share. Thank you so much.
Welcome. Yeah. And let me tell you that आपको कोई भी परेशानी है बच्चे के बारे में, feel free to contact Parisar Asha's helpline number. It's toll free helpline number. We are flashing it over here. You can, you know, take a screenshot, or otherwise you can Google also. This is free counseling. Anytime, सुबह 9 से लेके शाम को 9 बजे तक, रात को 9 बजे तक आप कभी भी फोन कर सकते हैं. If you feel कि बच्चे के साथ, if the child is having little concentration issues or aggression, depression, anxiety, ट्रॉमा कुछ भी, या फिर आपको लगता है बहुत एडिक्शन हो गया है स्क्रीन का, तो कैसे उसे हैंडल करे? बहुत बार बच्चा उल्टे मतलब जवाब देता है, तो उसे कैसे हैंडल किया जाए? तो ये सारे सवाल के जवाब हमारे जो काउंसलर्स हैं वो आपको देंगे, हेल्प यू आउट इन एनी सिचुएशन. ओके,
सो थैंक यू.
Workbooks are also now available for all the mothers and parents who are teaching their it's homeschooling. मतलब जो बच्चों को अभी help कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे,
yeah.
ये help के लिए we are keeping it open, so you can log on to our website or you can call us. So we will be happy to help you in any you know ways, whatever we can do the best for everyone who are stuck at home right now.
Yes, sure, ma'am. Thank you.
So anybody else would like to say something or should we close the session? Thank you, Geeta. Thank you, Dhanashri. Thank you, Dr. Sunita. It was really pleasure having all of you over here. And we always knew each other on the professional ground, but it is so nice to get connected as mothers. So thank you a lot. And stay safe, stay home. Take care of yourself. Thank you, Sukada. I think let's close it. And wish you all a very happy Mother's Day tomorrow. And every day is a Mother's Day. So enjoy your day with your mom or with your kids.
Thank you so much. Take care.